गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विथ हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कनेक्ट द ब्लूटूथ डिवाइसेस और हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू मेक द पेयरिंग ऑफ द ब्लूटूथ डिवाइसेस. नाउ वेन एवर यू आर गोइंग टू कनेक्ट विथ एनी एक्सटर्नल हार्डवेयर डिवाइसेस वी हैव टू कीप इन माइंड थ्री थिंग्स. नंबर वन, दैट इज एंड्रॉयड मैनिफेस्ट फाइल. सो देयर शुड बी वन सेटिंग इन द एंड्रॉयड मैनिफेस्ट फाइल. सेकेंड, वी हैव टू ड्रैग एंड ड्रॉप द रिक्वायर्ड कंट्रोल्स लाइक अ टेक्स्ट बॉक्स बटन फॉर पेयरिंग ऑफ द डिवाइसेस. And third, the Bluetooth connectivity programming. So first we are going to start with Android manifest file. So here is the manifest file. Here we want to make the connection for the Bluetooth. So these two sentences must be there. Number one, that is Android permission. So user's permission Android:name Android.permission.bluetooth and user's permission Android:name Android.permission.bluetooth admin. So these two sentences should be there in order to connect one Bluetooth device with the other Bluetooth device. So first thing is that there should be entry in the Android manifest file. Second, we have to drag and drop the controls. First, that is a text view. So in the text view, we have to write what are the Bluetooth connections we have to make. Second, I have taken one image for the display. Next, that is button. One button for the turn on and second button for the make visible. And third button for the list of the devices and fourth button for the turn off. And last one, that is list view. In the list view, we have to display what are the nearby devices present or connected with the Bluetooth device. And last text box, that is last label, that is for the pairing of devices. So these are the controls we have to drag and drop in the relative layout. So the coding is, first we have to drag and drop the relative layout. Once we drag and drop the relative layout, we have to make layout width and height as a match parent. Match parent means whatever the devices you are going to connect, or for any devices, the screen should be matched automatically. So that is meant by match parent. So most of the time we have seen this like this, the match parent. Match parent means you are going to automatically adjust the screen of the device. Next, that is context, that is .bluetooth. So this is the file, and Android transition group is true. We have drag and drop the text view. On the text view, I have written Bluetooth example. So when you see this view, so this is the Bluetooth example. After that, I have make the wrap content, layout width and layout height, that is wrap content. Now wrap content means on the screen it should adjust automatically, but not on the devices. But for the devices, we have to match the parent. So wrap the content means automatically it is going to adjust with the other controls. Now here is the ID. We have to, for every controls we have to give the ID. Now here is the text size, and these are the positions from aligned from the parent top and a layout central horizontal is true. Once we finish with the text view, there is another text view. Just we have written it for the test, means we have to check the connections. Now second is, I have drag and drop the image, and this image is nothing but, this is the image for the Bluetooth. So this is optional, if you want you can take the image, otherwise it is not needed. Next, that is a button for the turn on. When you click on this button, the Bluetooth is turned on. When you click on the other button, that is turn off, the button is going to turn off, that is the button 4. So like this we have done the drag and drop the controls. Now this is the last, that is list view. In the list view, we have to show all the display devices. So this was the code for the front end. Now at the back end, that is at the actual Java programming, what we have to do. Now here is the code for the Java. Now we have taken 4 buttons, that is B1, B1, 2, 3, 4. So these are the 4 controls. Next, that is Bluetooth adapter. Now this is the class. So here we have to import android.bluetooth.bluetoothadapter, again android.bluetooth.bluetoothdevice. So these are the classes we have to import. Now the button is also a class. So class Bluetooth activity extends activity. Now this button is B1, B2, B3, B4. After that we have taken private Bluetooth adapter BA. So this is the object of the Bluetooth adapter. Next we have taken a set. In the set we have passed the parameter as a Bluetooth device. This is also a class. And variable is paired devices. So this is the class we have imported. Now there is one method. So again there is a list view. In order to display the list of the devices, we have taken the list view. Now this is the protected word onCreate method. And in the onCreate method, we have set the layout. Now set content view, it is a method we called, and once we call the method, we have to pass the layout. So R is resources dot layout dot which layout, this is the activity underscore Bluetooth. So this layout is going to match with this Java file. Now after that we have to initialize the variables. Now the B1 is the object of a button class. It is a type of button. Find view by ID, it is a method. For this method we have to pass the parameters. Resource, which resource? Resource of the button, it should match with B1. So here we have to map all the controls we have drag and drop on the layout activity Bluetooth. So first we have to map the activity with the Java file, and after that we have to map all the controls from that XML file to the Java file. Now we have to first provide the default adapter. So Bluetooth object is BA. Now BA is the object already we have mentioned over here. Is equal to Bluetooth adapter and get default. This is the static method, get default adapter. Get default adapter is the static method present in the Bluetooth adapter. Now what are the return value it is assigned to the BA. Now first we have to check whether the default adapter have a value or not. If it does not have a value, that means the Bluetooth is not going to support the device. So here first we have to check BA is null. If the BA is null, it means that particular device has a no Bluetooth. So toast.make test get application context, that is current screen, and I want to display on the current screen, the not supported. That means the Bluetooth is not supported on this device. And this is the toast.lengthlong.show. So if the Bluetooth is not supported, we have to display on the toast message that it is not supported. If it has a support, then we have to list all the Bluetooth devices nearby. So LV, that is list view, find view by ID r.id.listView. So I have initialized list view. Second method we have taken, that is void view. Now if again B is null, we have to display not supported, otherwise we have to make the enable. Now else not BA is enabled, intent is equal to turn on. I want to make the turn on Bluetooth, I want to make the turn on. So what request I have to pass is equal to new intent Bluetooth adapter dot initial, sorry, action request enable. So when you make action request enable, it means that the Bluetooth is enabled for a particular device. So when you go on this, you will get all these strings constants available. So here is the Bluetooth adapter, and in the Bluetooth adapter class we can study all the strings. Okay, so turning on state on, turning off state, in state able on. So these all are variables present over here. So we have taken action request enable, that means I want to make the turn on. And after that I have called a method start activity for result, and turn on and the request code is 0. So here we have to make the Bluetooth turn on. After that I have just make toast, that is toast.make text get application context turn on, and a toast.length long and show. So I have to make the show of the Bluetooth is enabled. Otherwise I have to make that this is already on. So when is not enabled, then it should enable. If it is already enabled, then I want a display message it is already on, means Bluetooth is already on. So this is the code for the public word on. Now this is the method I have to call it. Second method I have written, that is off, public word off. First I have to make the disable, so ba.disable, and after that I want to make the toast message to display get application context, turn off, and length long and show. It means if the Bluetooth is not enabled, or sorry, if the Bluetooth is enabled, then I want to make the disable. So I'm going to call a method disable. Now once I make the disable, I want to display a message for the user. So I have written toast.makeTest get application context and turn on, and toast.bluetooth length long and Bluetooth is turned off. Now next we have to talk about the visible. Now once you can, if you enable a Bluetooth, so this was the end of the code off. Next code for the visible. Now suppose I want to make the Bluetooth device as a visible, then I want to call a constant action request discoverable. So how we are going to make this call? Intent get visible is equal to new intent Bluetooth adapter dot action request discoverable. So this is the constant we have to call. Once you call this constant, I want to call start activity for result. So start activity for result and get visible. So we have to make the visible, so I can make this as a discoverable. Next I want to display all the devices present over there. So public word list, I want to display the list, view, and paired devices, it is a class, is equal to ba.getBoundedDevices. Now this is the method readymade available to list all the devices display over there. Now I want to display all these into the array list. So array list of list is equal to new array list. Now for Bluetooth device BT, for Bluetooth device BT colon, that means it is a for each loop, pair devices, that means in all Bluetooth devices list dot add BT dot get name, toast dot make test get application context, text is showing paired devices, toast dot length short and show. I want to display that it is going to show all the paired devices. Now the final array adapter, that is adapter is equal to new array adapter, this dot android dot layout. Now this is the code to list out the, this is the code for the display of the list. Now final array adapter is equal to new array adapter, this it means current context, android dot r dot layout, simple list atom. Now simple list atom, you know, click on this. This is simple list atom 1. And I want to bind with the list. After that, LV, that is list view dot set adapter. This is the adapter I am going to set it. So this was the code to for the Bluetooth devices. Means in this code you can do everything. You can on the Bluetooth, you can off the Bluetooth, you can enable discoverable the Bluetooth, you can make the enable disable, you can make the list of all the nearby devices like this. So when I'm going to run this code, I want to make the change over here. So here I want to make as a Bluetooth, so I want to make this as a Bluetooth. Now here we want to make the change that the class name is a Bluetooth. So I want to run this class first, so I can make the change over here as a Bluetooth. So you can save this, and when you run this program, you will get the output for Bluetooth devices. Now here we have to write a class. Which class should which class should run first? So here is the name we have to change every time. And this is the code, already we have seen this code, how this code is going to be present over here. Now I want to run a Bluetooth code, so I have taken the Bluetooth should run first. So I'll just drag and drop the code. I will not make it as a clean. So I'm going to run this on the device. Now the build is successful. So now this is the code. Now when you make the turn on, okay, it is going to turn on. When you make the turn off, it is going to make the turn off. When you list devices, it is going to list and get visible. This device is going to visible to all other devices. So just I want to make these buttons line by line, but for the simplicity I will just drag and drop the controls. So when you click on the turn on, it is not supported because I'm going to running on the hardware. Means once you create the APK and when you take this APK into your mobile and you run it, you will get the correct output of this program. So this was a program for the Bluetooth device. This was a program present in the list also, and this was a part of the syllabus also. So if you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. Thank you.